Founded by former execs from Alienware that left when they were bought by Dell in 2009, Origin, which was actually named apparently for their wanting to get back to their origins of just making gaming computers, is a bit of an underdog in the gaming computer industry. Now, they were kind enough to send me one of their 15-inch gaming laptops called the Origin Evo 15S. And so I figured I would try to do one of my complete walkthroughs for you guys. Now, if you're not familiar, a complete walkthrough on this channel is where I try to go through every single feature that I possibly can on a new device so that you guys are better prepared and have more information should you be in the market to buy one. Now, with that said, there is a lot to go through as always. So let's get started with the hardware. Now, the chassis is thin enough at the 0.7-inch mark and weighs about 4.3 pounds, so it's also portable enough. Now, one thing that is a bit unique to Origin and is a big part of their philosophy, apparently, is that they have the ability to customize the laptop case when you order it. From HD UV prints that have a bit of a 3D effect to metallic colors, complete themes, and you can even do custom laser etching or paint if you want for an additional 50 bucks. So you've got plenty of options. Now, the 15.6 inch screen on this is available in three options: a 1080p matte IPS display, a 1080p 144Hz matte display, and a 4K IPS matte display. Above that display, we have a 2-megapixel 1080p front-facing camera. And below it are integrated Sound Blaster X Pro gaming speakers, and beneath that are three-zone customizable RGB keyboard and a precision trackpad with a built-in fingerprint scanner for Windows Hello. Now, for ports, on the left side, we have two USB 3.1 ports. We also have two USB 3.1 USB Type-C ports, two display ports, an HDMI port, and our power AC adapter port. On the right, we have our microphone in port, our headphone out port, our USB 3.1 port, a SD card MMC slot, as well as a micro SD card slot, which is kind of cool, and an Ethernet port. Inside the computer, we have an Intel i7-8750H 6-core processor and an NVIDIA GTX 1070 Max-Q GPU. For RAM, we have the choice of 2400 megahertz RAM in 8, 16, or 32 gigs, or 2666 megahertz RAM in either 16 or 32 gigs. For storage, we have a lot of choices. See their philosophy on customization that I mentioned. You have an M.2 SSD choice of 250 gigs, 500 gigs, 1 terabyte, or 2 terabytes in either PCIe or SATA, and you get a choice of an additional hard drive in 250 gigs, 500, 1 terabyte, 2 terabytes, or 4 terabytes in an SSD, 2 terabytes in a mechanical hard drive, or 500 gigs, 1 terabyte, or 2 terabytes in a flash accelerated hybrid drive. For connectivity, we have Intel dual band Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5.0. For battery, Origin doesn't list the specific watt hour size, but they claim it'll do about 5 hours of video playback. For software, it comes with either Windows 10 Home or Windows 10 Pro. Either way, you're probably familiar with Windows, so we'll skip going through that, and let's talk about the software that Origin has included that stands out. First up, I just have to say that there's no bloatware on this thing. It has the least amount of programs installed on a Windows PC that I've seen in a very long time, which I appreciate. Other than that, we do have a program that is installed to help you control all of the RGB colors, as well as things like see the clock speed of your processors, the temperature, your fan, and control all of those types of things that we see on pretty much every gaming laptop. Now, I use gaming laptops to edit my videos on, since the same components that make these guys good at gaming is the same that makes them good at running Premiere Pro, which is the video editing software I use. So let's render a video out and see how long that takes and compare it to the speeds and times of other similar laptops that I've tested recently. And now, let's check it out to see how it does in 3D Mark's Firestrike test, so you guys can use that number to compare it to other similar laptops as well. And also, here's a few of the other laptops that I also tested recently and what they scored. Now, for the cons for this laptop for me, the keyboard has a number pad on the right side, which most laptops don't, and so you find yourself actually having to use the keyboard pretty slanted to the left, which was hard for me to get used to, but maybe that's just me. The bezels do feel a little outdated because they're a lot bigger now with all these other thinner bezeled laptops coming out, as well as the chassis, with all these other laptops having much more premium materials and metals and all this other kind of stuff. And then finally, the battery life is not quite as good as some of those other laptops as well. Now on the plus side though, it is less expensive than all of those other laptops. Also, because it's not made out of those same materials, it does feel a lot lighter. It's customizable, not just in the styling, and by the way, I really like this like custom gray from my logo top that they did. Real nice. But also in every other way imaginable. So there is bound to be some sort of configuration for your needs if you're looking to buy this laptop. Now also the performance is basically on par with those other more expensive laptops, even if the battery life is slightly less. And then there's also honestly just something about me that likes the fact that this company kind of feels like a startup. They feel like this scrappy, smaller company that sends the t-shirt and the poster and the wooden crate that you have to open with a drill. You know, they just seem like they try to make every customer feel special. And I don't know about you guys, but that definitely adds to the appeal of owning one of these, for me at least. There guys, link below to the best price that I could find this laptop, and if you just wanna check it out for yourself. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Let me know what you think of the laptop and of this video in the comments below. Always good to hear from you guys. And if you liked this video, please thumbs up it or share it. It's greatly appreciated. And if you want more videos like this, please check out the rest of my channel and subscribe if you like what you see there, and hit the bell next to the word subscribe so you get notified when I do new videos. As always though, regardless, thanks for watching.